Welcome to this module on citizens and air quality in Amsterdam and Kampala. In the previous module, we explored the topic of co-creation and air quality in Beijing. Now we will continue by investigating how citizens engage with sustainability transitions for a better urban air quality in the cities of Amsterdam and Kampala. We start in Amsterdam with an introduction to the city's air quality from a meteorological perspective. Although you may expect differently, we will see that air pollution is a major issue in Amsterdam nowadays. Particulate matter receives special attention by scientists, policymakers, citizens, and NGOs. In particular, major variances in the concentrations of particulate matter on a street level challenges traditional air quality monitoring by government authorities. NGOs like Waag Society have been collaborating with citizens and other stakeholders to develop new ways to monitor air quality. We will look at some of these projects where citizens living in neighborhoods with potentially high levels of pollution start monitoring the air quality. This raises questions on citizen science and the role of scientific knowledge and expertise, but also on the meaning of sensors, monitoring, and big data for citizens' everyday life. Halfway through the module, we zoom in on the topic of smart cities and smart citizens to address these questions. The second city that we will visit in this module is Kampala. As a prototype of cities of the global south, the social technical systems of Kampala developed very differently from those in both Amsterdam and Beijing. We specifically address the air quality in large slum areas where many of the urban poor live. We will learn about charcoal cooking, which is a daily practice and a major source of energy for many people living in Kampala's suburban areas. Because people burn coal in and around their houses, the health effects are very significant. This is recognized by many NGOs and CBOs that try to develop alternatives for the polluting charcoal stoves. So far, however, most of these projects failed in their implementation phase, and alternative stoves, like the so-called improved charcoal stoves, have a very low uptake. Two questions will be at the heart of this section on Kampala's air quality. First, how can the failure of this alternative cooking stove be understood in light of the social, technical, and political context of Kampala? And secondly, how can and do citizens in Kampala slum areas co-create more healthy and sustainable cooking practices that improve the air quality? We explore these questions together with you and also encourage you to come up with answers on these challenging questions. By the end of this module, we have finished the topic of air quality for this entire MOOC. We close this topic with a panel discussion in which we readdress the three cities and the different forms of co-creation that we have come across in their different social, technical, and political contexts. I hope you will enjoy this module, and we are looking forward to your feedback.